Hey guys, in this video I will be talking about management of components on a page, specifically the fundamental functions of adding components to a page, moving them around, replicating components, deleting components from the page. Not so much designing your application and certainly not adding logic, but right now we will be exploring more of a basic fundamental functions that you need to be aware of as you start using UI Builder and developing applications with it. For the demonstration purposes and to explore the management functions of components, I created a page using the landing template. The page name is Demo. The components are located in this toolbox. There are multiple components, and there are several components that you need to be aware of that imply a particular behavior when they lay out their child components. Specifically, let's start with the container. I'm going to move one. The container consists of a row and a cell. You can add multiple rows. A single row can contain multiple cells. But right now, we will be exploring just the functions of moving them around, deleting components, and so on. So as you saw, adding a component to a page is as simple as dragging one right from the toolbox right onto the page. Whenever you drag it around, there is this green line that indicates where it can go. And there are different positions, so depending on the way you move it around, it indicates where it will be placed. So as soon as you release the mouse button, that component is placed. If you have a component and you want to get rid of it, select the component and the entire area is highlighted. When you hit the delete button, it will go away. Something to keep in mind, whenever you have a component selected, there are breadcrumbs right here in the upper right corner that indicate the placement of that component in relationship to its parent. So here we have block 4, which is contained by block 2. So if I select block 2, then the whole area is selected. Once again, once a component is selected and you get this thick blue line indicating what component it is, you can hit the delete button to delete it. Or for any currently selected component, there is a little panel right here with icons, and we'll review most of them in here, that each icon, of course, implies a particular action. So to delete it, click the bin, the trash icon, as I do right now, and that component is removed. Now, let's say we have this cell selected, and let's review the behavior of this icon right here, which points up. What this icon does is it will move up the tree of the breadcrumbs of the placement of this component. So here, cell 2, notice in the breadcrumbs, it is located in row 2. So if we have cell 2 selected and click the arrow up, then the parent will be selected, which is row 2. And then if we click arrow up, then from row 2 we'll go to container 2. And notice that I click it, and now container 2 is selected. So this is how you can traverse the selection of the current component in the tree depending on the placement. Let's select the cell and apply some property. For instance, we select the background color of the cell, and this could be anything. What I'm going to show you, it will be the copying of this component, replicating it. It doesn't have to be cell, it could literally be any component with all the logic associated with it. To replicate it, you can simply click this icon right here, which is a copy. So if I click it, notice that there is going to be a replica of this component. If I select this row and I replicate it, now we have replica of the row with these two cells. If I select the entire container and I replicate it, now we have a replica of the container with all the children in it replicated. So this is quite convenient whenever you building out the page and you quickly need to replicate the contents of a portion of that page. Let me clean it up so we have fewer components. It becomes a lot easier to explain. Let me replicate the cell and assign different colors to it, and I will you will see why I'm doing it. So here, this one will become green, and this one will be, for instance, blue. Okay, so now we have three components, and for instance, if I want to move them around, once again, select the component that you need to move, and notice that this icon with arrows pointing in all directions, that's the one that lets you move. So select the component and then press and hold the arrow. As you move it around, notice that there is still this green line that indicates where that component will be. As soon as you release it, now red moved to the right side of the row. Select blue, it is indicated that it's selected by the fact that you have cell selected right here, and you have this little panel with the icons, so we'll move it to be the first one, and now blue is the first one. So that's how you move the components around. If you have more than one row, so let's just select the row and replicate this row, and let's say I want to move this cell into the second row, you can also do that. So now second row contains two red cells. So as you can see, moving components around is very, very easy. Various components, such as, for instance, row, they imply a direction in which the cells will be replicated. So in a row, cells go from left to right. So if I create a copy of the cell and it reaches the end, then it will continue replicating from left to right, top to bottom. If you select block, for instance, and let me move block into here, and then inside of this block, I will place an image. So we have an image, I will also place a text, and I will also place an icon. So now we have image, text, and icon. Notice that the components, the children of this block, are organized top to bottom. The reason they're organized this way is because a block component has a property called direction. And then here, as you can see, it's top to bottom. You can change it to be left to right, and then it immediately reorganizes. It can be bottom to top, and now the order is reversed, and it can be right to left. So in this case, you can control the actual flow, but this is more of a getting into the topic of creating the layout. But in here, this could also be important as you move the components around, because the direction implies where it will be positioned once you move it around. So just to recap, we talked about adding components to the page, replicating components, deleting components, moving them around. And that's the scope of this video. Thank you for watching, and as always, happy codeless coding.